thermal process. Okay, in our thermodynamics we are having two types of the process. One is isothermal process, next second one is adiabatic process. Isothermal process, next one adiabatic process. First one isothermal process, next one adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. Okay, what is the isothermal process and what is the adiabatic process will do? Okay, the process in which pressure, what we see isothermal, we are using two words, the process which, now I will tell the definition. The process in which pressure and volume are changes. Pressure and volume are changes at temperature. Okay, what is the isothermal process? The process in which pressure and volume are changes at constant temperature is called isothermal process. Then what we can say simply, PV is equal to constant. This is which process? Isothermal process. Okay, next, come to this side, adiabatic process. What is adiabatic? The process, same definition will come here, the process in which pressure and volume are changes at constant heat. What is the extra word here? Here what is the constant letter? Heat is called adiabatic process. Here what will come here? Then gamma is equal to some k. This is the definition of isothermal process and adiabatic process. Okay, in the isothermal process we are having work done, in the isothermal process how much work you have done on the system. Okay, for that we are having the definition, work done in isothermal process, very important. Okay, in the exam you will get, in the exam you will get questions. Okay, define the isothermal process and work done in isothermal process. Question. Okay, work done, work done, work done in isothermal process. Four marks, very important. Okay, work done in isothermal process. Okay, for this we have to prove that equation. So for this purpose, what you first I have to consider, the 1 gram of mole gas is there in with S. Okay, that mole of gas definitely it has how much we are having, it has pressure and volume also, but it, where should be it there? It should be at the constant temperatures. Okay, so the work done on the system, okay, the work done by the the work done by the gas. Okay, what happened? The work done by the gas or the work done by the heat? The work done by the heat gas. How much is there? That you tell me. Already I said about how much is there, that is dq is equal to how much I said d, or else we can say dq is equal to what is the formula, du plus dw we are having. Okay, from we no need to take this equation, simply we have to take that work done. What is the work done? Dw is equal to pdv we have to take. Okay, in this equation the work done by the heat gas, so how much is the work done by ETU? So that is dw is equal to pdv. So next, the work, from where to where the work is done. So how much is there the pressure? What happened? P1 to, suppose let us take what you have taken here, P pressure you have taken, volume you have taken. Okay, from pressure, pressure what, P1 to next P2, volume from where to where, V1 to V2. Okay, so simply what you have to do, you have to do the differentiation both sides. So what happened, if you take the integration on both sides, then what happened, from where to where, pressure, sorry, what is there here, see, pdv. T1 to T2, then we can take that is volume V1 to V2. So already we are having the p value, simply substituting this p value here, then what happened, w is equal to integration nrt dv by v, so that is volume from where to where, v1 to v2. So this is n also constant, r also constant, t also constant, then what happened, w is equal to nrt next integration v1, see what happened, w is equal to nrt v1 to v2 1 by v dv. So already you know the integration 1 by x dx, what happened, log x is log of a minus b is equal to log a by b formula, that is a formula. If you remove this, what happened, 2.3. So this is the work done in isothermal process. How much you are getting? The work done total is equal, what is the formula? W is equal 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1. So here N is equal to, you know, N is equal to moles, R is equal to constant, T also you know, V2 also they will get, you will get, V1 also you will get. Then we can find that all these values in this equation, then we can find out the how much work done in the isothermal process. Okay, this is about the isothermal process. Simply you will get question, okay, define the what is the isothermal process, derive the equation for isothermal process, then you have to take like this, then you have to do the this formation, you have to do, then you will get answer.